Since for a couple of decades now, I've been studying immunoregulatory mechanism in both neoplasia and also autoimmunity and chronic inflammatory diseases. In particular, for the study of juvenile diabetes, we discovered as soon as 2003 that non-obese diabetic mice, which represent the most important experimental model for the studies of human autoimmune diabetes, are defective in the expression of an immunoregulatory enzyme, which is indolamine-2,3-dioxygenase-1. This enzyme catalyzes the catabolism of the essential amino acid tryptophan into a series of immunoactive molecules collectively known as canurinins. And later on, we also discovered that the defect of IDO1 in NOD mice is related to an overexpression of a pro-inflammatory cytokine interleukin-6 in response to microbial signals. So we very recently we started a study investigating whether IDO1 defect could also be observed in peripheral blood mononuclear cells obtained from children with type 1 diabetes as compared to children with no autoimmune diseases. And what we found is that IDO1 is also defective in human pediatric patients affected by type 1 diabetes. And this is related to a genotypic polymorphism of the enzyme. And is more related rather than an excess of interleukin-6 production by an overexpression of the receptor recognizing interleukin-6. Therefore, by using an interleukin-6 receptor blocker, which is tocilizumab, a drug that is also used in the therapy of juvenile arthritis, we were able to demonstrate that the defect of IDO1 can be corrected, although not in all PBN, not in all cells from all type 1 diabetic patients, but only from 1/3 of diabetic patients. So therefore, our data are important because they demonstrate that there is an important IDO defect also in human type 1 diabetes, and that we can correct this defect by pharmacologic maneuvers in some of these patients, and that finally, probably, we would require a personalized medicine to obtain an effective cure for all type 1 diabetic patients.